Arsenal is not the best women club in Europe. We have to look at it that way.
Okay.
There is hype. They have the press in Britain and all that. But you go to the Scandinavian countries in like Denmark, Sweden, Norway, Finland. Then you go to Germany. Germany, as of today, they hold the, you know, they hold the assets when it comes to women football. So I think she should aspire to get to those
in that direction.
Yes. Okay. And you know, they have the Women's Champions League.
Mm-hmm.
And none of the English teams have been able to win it in recent times. You understand what I'm saying? So we have to see a way of, you know, trying to push her to that level of getting to that position.
Yeah.
Because she has not really arrived.
I think,
and again, she also have to make a little impact on the national team.
Okay.
I mean, the Falcons, you know, they are going toward through a kind of diminishing returns. And somebody like her, I think,
needs to help
be able
raise,
to, yes, raise the standard
of that team.
Yeah.
Two Olympics now. Olympics back to back. London 2012. Next is Rio
2016.
The Falcons will not be there. It's unheard of that a team is representing the continent in the global competition, and it's not Nigeria.
Okay.
Now, you have to look against the backdrop of the progress made by other countries. South Africa will be represented by both the men and the women's team at the Olympics. Nigeria, the women are not going there. The African Women's Championship, even at that, there are so many competitions coming from South Africa, from Equatorial Guinea, and all of that. I think she has to assert herself more. That of being the best team in England in the Champions League, I think for Arsenal perhaps might be building for that, and they might just want to say, okay, this, let's make her part of the jigsaw to see us.
That will get us to that level.
Yeah.
All right, guys, before we leave this issue and go to something else, quickly, do you see her? I just want a straightforward answer so that we can move on. Let me start with Chris. Do you see her getting as far as winning the Ballon d'Or for the women in say, next 5 years?
Yeah. If you leave the shores of this country, where you have so many contradictions,
many challenges,
where you have so many problems, even the roads that players pass through to go and play matches, it's a nightmare. When you leave the shores of this country and you get to Europe, Europe is the pinnacle of football in the world, take it or leave it. I think the facilities that is at the disposal of Arsenal, she will go places.
Okay.
That is my belief.
Okay. Will you be bold enough to say maybe she could win or not?
I think it's possible.
Okay.
It's possible, realistically, because when you look at the level she has attained, she won the best player at the, you know, one of the World Youth Under 20 World Cup. That tells you, even at that level with the German and everybody, she has the potential to do all of that. But she has to first assert her place in the national team.
Okay.
And, of course, move on from there.
Take it up from there.
All right. I think we should go on a quick break. Let's quickly go on a break. When we come back, we'll be talking about the Nigeria Super Eagles. We'll be talking about our clubs on the continent. A lot still on the show for you tonight. Just sit back, relax. We'll go on this break. We'll come back for more on Sports Tonight. Guys, let's quickly go on the show and let's talk about our teams on the continent. Chris, it's going to be a two-in-one question. Let's go to the CAF Confederations Cup. Nasarawa United working on teen heists. Do you think they'll be able to do what's necessary to still remain in the competition? And by the way, what do they need to do right there in Algeria?
You see, I will have to be honest with you. And you see, if you look at the match that was played and the circumstances that led to the only goal of the match, you find out that the Nasarawa United players were not consistent. I will put it that way. And when you are playing against a North African opposition on your home soil, you take all your chances. Because when you get there to Algeria, they will do all kinds of things. You know, one, the weather is against them now. In Algeria right now, there is cold. You look at that. Secondly, we know the Algerians, we know the antecedents over the years.
Yeah.
They will do everything possible to make sure that they get the goals they need. And the Algerian team needs just two goals. And this Nasarawa United team I saw, from all indications, if I have to be very, very realistic and objective, I don't think they can scale.
What should they do? What do you think they should do?
What I think they should do right now is already late. Because, you see, like, if we have to be honest, we don't go these days, you don't play football on the pages of newspapers, okay, or you go to TV stations and make noise. You start your preparations well in advance, and right, so that on the D-Day you get the results you need, or you don't go to the churches and mosques and start praying when you see, okay, like what I'm trying to say is this: anything can happen in football. I know that I'm not ruling out that, but the Nasarawa United I saw, I don't think I'm able to scale the Ojora hurdle.
Okay, all right. Before we go to the CAF Champions, I don't know if that's your verdict as well.
No, that's not my verdict. I know that I spoke to some players in Nasarawa United. I said, it's like, you guys, the only way you know how to do things is the hard way. Recall that their last game was against
the same
Generation Foot of
Senegal.
Yeah, but you don't do the same thing all over again.
What I'm saying is this is football.
Yeah.
The Algerians came here with a plan, and that plan is to frustrate, try as much as possible not to concede. It's always easier to defend than to attack. Now, you will agree with me that 1-0 is better than goalless.
Yeah.
It's better than goalless or 1-1.
Or conceding, so now, or letting them score and away.
Now, instead of just sitting back and waiting for Nasarawa United to attack, they will now have to come out. And in coming out, it means they will leave gaps at the back. Okay. I'm not ruling Nasarawa out completely. I think they have a chance.
Okay, let's go to the CAF Champions League. That's where... let's start with the one that looks pretty easy. But anything can happen in football, like you guys have said. Vitalo and Enyimba.
I think Enyimba is there already. There are no questions about that, because if you can look at the pedigree, most times we look at the pedigree of the team in question. You know, it's not as if in recent times Enyimba have been able to have been wonderful or so to say, but Enyimba against Vital, I believe strongly that they are already in the next round.
Okay, now let's talk about the one that kind of leave a bitter taste in our mouth. Warriors lost at home, they're going away. It's a tricky time.
Yes, and for the Warri players, they seem pretty upbeat. I was with them yesterday, just before they left. They seem very upbeat. That El Merrick for them had just two chances in Warri and buried one of them. Warri had several. In fact, good luck Onomadu, the captain, to tell me that from the morning of the game, it rained all through. It was like, when is this rain going to stop? And so it made it difficult for them.
Made life difficult for them. Yeah.
That they had like 3 1-on-1 chances with the goalkeeper, they didn't take it. So, and the coach, Peter Nyeketin, former international, did make the point that he would have been worried if Warri Wolves was not creating chances. But he knows that the team, they are creating chances, and hopefully...